Hello everyone.
My name is Donovan Mayo, aka Donovan Mayo 46. I'm widely known on TikTok as a cosplayer and roleplayer.
Diving straight into this apology video, and bro is already capping. He is not widely known. Just for context, for those who don't know who this sexy beast is, his name is Donovan Mayo, and he's your ordinary 21-year-old obese degenerate that dwells in his parents' basement and makes cringy TikToks all day. Just to give you a small taste, just a mere sample of what kind of content this guy makes, I'll show you a TikTok of his, and feel free to prepare some bleach for your eyes. Yeah, as you can see, his TikToks are insanely cringe, and there's just something about him that's slightly offsetting. In most of his videos, he usually talks about anime, video games, and indulges in his infamous roleplay we'll see more of later in this video. Since this kind of content attracts a younger audience on TikTok, I'm sure you guys can see where this apology video is headed. Now that we got his introduction out of the way, let's get back into the video.
But behind the scenes, I was roleplaying with minors, but didn't know at the time. I didn't care to ask their age.
It's kind of funny how this whole mishap could have easily been prevented if bro just asked their age. I feel like that's like the most important detail you should find out before you do some freaky kinky roleplay with another person in the first place. Especially being a 21-year-old on an app like TikTok.
And this was my fault on my part. Being the older one. In fact, here's one of the messages that I was roleplaying with.
At least bro cited his source and is willing to provide evidence, unlike Colina Ballinger's apology video where she denied claims that she was sending weird messages to minors, but then had absolutely no evidence to support her. Props to Donovan for growing a pair and being willing to tell the world what he said from his notebook. He looks at his notebook and goes, After looking over at his messages with the minor, it's like he just reached nirvana and was finally enlightened after all this time. It's as if in this moment in his head he was like, oh, that's my bad, guys. Now that I'm getting a good look at it, maybe I did make a little oopsie.
Someone was asking, is this secret between us? Maybe people will think I'm too young for you. And in reply, I said, it's all secret. Besides, my age is unlisted and unknown. And furthermore, I said, now stop playing coy with me.
There is no way. There is just no way anybody can convince me this guy is a real person. And also, this is kind of off topic, but is using the word coy riz? Me personally, I've never used that word before, and women don't seem very fond of me. So maybe I'll try it out and let you guys know how it goes.
Your number one fan is waiting. Besides, I have something for you. Sorry, something with me. Don't worry about it. I'm afraid they did worry about it.
Yeah, obviously they worried about it. Also, his face right here kind of makes it look like he's disappointed he got exposed. I'm extremely grateful that this guy was caught, because there's no saying what he would have done if he wasn't. As of recording this video, his main account is banned on TikTok, but it's unsure if it was for talking to minors or something else, like the thing he's about to say next in this video.
Either way, in a live stream, I also said that I tied someone up.
You can't casually say either way and then admit to a felony. I don't know what kind of freaky TikTok lives this guy hosts, but I can tell you that it is not suitable for children. Like, does this guy really not have anything better to do in his life than be a weirdo on the internet?
Which was a lie. But that wasn't cool. Last I checked.
I don't know if it's just me, but the words he uses or just the way he talks makes it sound like he's roleplaying in the middle of his apology video. Like, I'm not gonna lie, it does make the video pretty engaging, but I don't think he should be doing it in a video where he's apologizing for engaging in not safe for work roleplay with minors.
So, I am making action and making sure that this never happens again. So this is to all my followers that I am sorry. This is me doing the thug shaker. To prove that I am truly sorry and serious about all this.
Now, in what world does doing the thug shaker mean you're truly sorry for talking to minors? It's like he expects the viewer to be like, oh crap, he just did the thug shaker. This apology just got real. Like, I'm just so curious how his pedophilic brain is able to function in the first place.
That is all. Thank you very much for hearing me out. Donovan Mayo, out. For good.
He finishes his apology video by saying he's out for good, like it's his choice or something. As I mentioned before, his TikTok account did get banned, so I don't know how he'd be able to come back in the first place. Overall, this apology wasn't as bad as Colleen Ballinger's, so that was a big plus. But his roleplay accent, or whatever you'd like to call it, did make it hard to watch without cringing. Not to mention the fact he shaked his ass to convince the viewer he was serious about his apology. I'll just wrap this up by going over some of my favorite comments on this apology video. Seth says, "This is genuinely one of the best apologies I've seen on this app, not gonna lie, because ain't seen no one hit the thug shaker to apologize, crying emoji, crying emoji." Gamer says, "Thank you, Donovan Mayo, you're good in my book." LV Visual says, "When I'm on my deathbed and they ask what time I'd want back, this. I want these 2 minutes and 12 seconds back." But if you're still watching this video, it was a bit longer than 2 minutes and 12 seconds. And also, thanks for watching till the end. I don't think we'll be seeing Donovan Mayo any soon, but if we do, he'll probably be behind bars or something or on the news. Anyways, have a good one.